So, I've got a bunch to cover real quick before we set up the new head. HUD. Okay, first of all, I got the egg from Bamboo, and it is right on the edge of hatching. I know this because I kept saving, taking a bunch of back and forth, saving, you know, and then I finally hatched and I loaded back so that I could catch it, here it is, so I could catch it hatching. So I wanted to make sure I started with that. I haven't seen what was in the egg. I cut it as soon as it started hatching. Oh. It's a squirrel. Thanks, Bamboo. Okay, I didn't know what I was gonna get, but I wasn't expecting a squirrel. Oh, it's a dragon fairy. Well, I mean, why not a squirrel be a dragon? Cats have been dragons and Lunar, so, you know. Heightens the critical hit ratios. Not too bad. I wonder if you evolved to be... Well, I mean, you're a dragon. You're gonna evolve to be something awesome, I hope. Maybe. That Earth Dragon ain't so great. Anyway, let's look at our other Pokemon before we do the HUD. Okay, so I spent an interminable amount of time just doing, you know, leveling and stuff. I discovered that, thanks to Flight, I could do every single rebattle, and then all the rebattles would be gone, and I'd have to wait a whole bunch. So I discovered that it was actually based on how much you do walking, so by walking back and forth, I get the rebattles to come back. I also could trade at the ninjas all I wanted, and did that a whole bunch. The one that's nothing but gargoyles is super easy to train against for certain Pokemon, not others. Frostthrow wasn't very good at it. You'd think it would be, with ice, but it wasn't. So, okay. I tried running around that village looking for hints. I'm so sure that this thing's supposed to evolve, again. They've got a statue that's pretty sure. But, no... No stones have done it. It's level 62. I have half a mind to just set it aside. I mean, what evolves at a higher level than 62? Grief. I think Dragonite was 60, I think. And I was really, you know, this is really getting tedious. Anyway, this thing, it's weird. It's called the three-legged Pokemon, I think, in the Pokedex. And you can see it's got 3 feet. So, it's still a pun. A vulture. I know, I don't want this piece of hard work is. Anyway, I also learned Dragon Pulse, which was weird. But when I was screwing with the stones. No, wait. Yeah, I bought more of all the stones. I need shiny stone. Check this out. So, let's see what this turns into first. Because there's one more thing relating to this. I'd pick this kind of on a whim, just because, I don't know, I kind of thought it was... It's a Kirin. Yeah, a Kiricorn. Yeah, it's a Kirin. Thing. Anyway, cool. Kirincorn. Crap, do I have it? I know I have it. Where'd it go? Did I screw up somehow? So I know I loaded back at one point. I bet I screwed up somehow. There was a thing. I hadn't even remembered it was a there was a thing. Yeah, I'm real descriptive here today. What we need to do is we need to get back to this. And in the Ninja Village, while I was asking around trying to figure out how to make my thing evolve, my Voltcher, Stormbringer. I should have called it, if I'd known it was going to turn to that, I would have called it Voltcher. But anyway. Okay. We need to fly over here. There was, when I showed the Minicorn to somebody that had wanted to see it, that I'd forgotten was even a thing, they gave me one of the Mega Evolution things. I assume for it. It's gotta be for it. I should have it on hand. It was this kid. This kid. Oh shit. It's not a minicorn anymore. I screwed up. How did I screw this up? Hey, it worked! She accepted it. Sure. Kiracornite, yes, definitely, definitely, perfect. Okay, so yeah, I had loaded back, like I said, I'd been mucking around trying to hatch the egg. I know it started hatching and I loaded back, and then I started doing a back and forth thing because I wasn't sure how far back I had loaded, so I just kind of went back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, save, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, save, until it started cracking, and then I loaded and started recording. So anyway, we have a new Mega Evolution to do. So, this might... yeah. Okay. And, I guess I'm gonna give... Oops, no, that's not right. I guess I'm gonna give Stormbringer my experience share. And Lexi here, I'm just gonna put the squirrel away, grab a different Pokemon. That will be our six for today. I'll start up my hut and we'll go back to Victory Road with, well, I didn't really gain all that many levels with my regulars. I just got some new members to the team. Even Frost, I had trouble leveling Frostthorpe for some reason. It keeps fainting. It's fast, it hits okay, but it's soft. It's soft and squishy, and not likely to stay in my team for ever. I'm so curious about so many of the Pokemon in this game. I kinda want Super Luck here to level. Alright, we want you back. I also leveled this one a little. So we have a few interesting options. But I do believe that for the time being, this will be my team, and we will check out a new Mega Evolution. Alright, let me get the HUD going. And there we are! Oops! There we go. Okay, sound back in. I have confidence in this party. I almost have confidence in this party. I think we can handle the rest of Victory Road. Maybe. I hope. But I'm not quite so sure about what happens when I get to the end of it. Probably terrible, terrible things happen when I get to the end of it. Alright, let's do this thing. First, though, all those trainery battles and everything, I have spent some of the money already, but I should spend more of the money. I did purchase at least a few revives. I forget what else I purchased. Garbage. Probably bought TMs or something stupid. I mean, TMs are really, really good. It's just... there's a lot of TMs I'm never going to use, and I know I'm never going to use them, and it's not enough to collect Pokemon. I have to collect other things, too, like TMs. Why do I need to collect technical machines? I don't even know. I just want them all. Okay. But we have a ton of money. I can be absolutely 100% positive that I got this now. We will not run out of supplies anytime soon. And best of all, I picked all the Lepa berries that I planted. So. I just kept doing the Lepa berry thing. So I have, okay, not nearly enough, but I have some PowerPoint recovery stuff. Wait, power cell? What was that? Okay, yeah, I also, pulled out some, stuff. At some point, I think it was elixirs. The top floor of this place, on weekdays, not on weekends, unfortunately. I'm recording this one on a weekend. But on weekdays on the top floor, they sell stuff. I thought it was random, but it's actually scripted. And one of those things is elixirs. Unfortunately, I didn't buy many of them. I don't know where the max ether came from, but I had stuffed a few things in my PC during the game. So I had a few things, but anyway, I'm sure we'll get by on PowerPoints. I'm sure we'll get by somehow. If we can handle the just... Hello, Larry! No, I'm done rebattling for now. Okay. Okay. Trying to psych myself up mentally for this. First, let's check out our new Mega Evolution. Before I go spraying repels, let's see what we can do! Definitely sound like a Rapidash. Okay, so I still got me first. I've got an attack, a healing, and I've got strength. Oh, is that three horns? I gotta see your front sprite. You are very strange from behind. What are we looking at here? Yeah, that would be fairly intimidating. The horns make it look more like a demon than a fairy, if you ask me. Yeah. So, I am happy to hate to lose. Right. I don't know what quiet nature, I don't know what that does to stats. Reflects status-changing moves. Ah, this is a beast. So I am very satisfied already with my Hell Fairy Pony. We'll have to see as we travel onward if I remain satisfied with it. Yeah, let's level it up more. These three are definitely behind the curve. I mean, I should be leveling up you, but I really should be leveling up this one. Should honestly take the experience share off. You know what? We'll just go with this, okay? Let's just do this. I'm sure that when this is all said and done and I actually see the Elite Four, I'm going to spend more time planting berries, leveling Pokemon, and generally prepping. Okay, I already beat you. This music is still epic. Frickin' epic. I didn't run a repel without realizing it, did I? Oh, okay, there we go. Oh, I still need to catch another one of you. But not right now. Oh yeah, this thing learned X-Scissor, which is gives it a bug-type technique, finally. Which, is good and all, but I don't think you can take down a bear yet. I don't think... I think all that wool is gonna make it somewhat resilient to your ice. Kinda wanna hit you with a flight. Alright, look, you can do this. I take it back. I have confidence in you. Hit. Most of it's not got any of that fur on it. You can freeze its legs. There we go! And you're more powerful. Ah, that's why when I used X-Scissor it was terrible. I just realized something about this Pokemon. I really hope you have a Mega Evolution, by the way. Your attack power is abysmal. X-Scissor and also Ice Ball, I did try that once. That's why those are terrible. I need to be rid of them. You need... Let's dig through my TMs here. Tell me, how about infestation? Huh, Escartris can infest things? That's weird. Nope, no good. Can I get a bug technique in special, please? I don't think I have anything like that. I don't think I have anything like that. Drat, I'm sure that I do not. Alright, let's get out of here. I have too many TMs. I mean, I have just so many TMs at this point. I think there are still more that I haven't bought, too. Here's another one for you. 71. Why not? We'll take a quick peek at it. High crit ratio. Rock type. Yeah, I can't use it. Oh, I know where I am. Well, I may as well take this. What's that? What's that? Binding moves? It's a rubber band. What's a binding move? No, really, what is a binding move? I don't understand. You mean like wrap? Fire spin? Are those binding moves? Whatever. I think this one could be taken down with a freeze dry. This should be 4x damage. I really like the move freeze dry. I mean, I just really like the idea of a move that's super effective against an additional type, in this case, water. I wish that I had more moves that affected extra types like that. That's amazing to me. Drat. See, bug is resistant to fighting, but ice is weak to bug, so it all balances out in the end. Drat. Well, that's it for Frostera. Good thing I just bought a lot of revives. I think Stormbringer can finish this. Alright. Oh yeah, it's got Roost now. I was happy to pick that up. Oh no! I needed to visit a POKeMON Center! Not that your Dragon-type move is particularly great anyway, so... I mean, it's alright, but it's, you know, I'd rather hit with flying or electric, since that's what it is. And I forgot to use my revive. Oh, these are random encounters. Where's my repels? What am I doing? I'm getting tore up by random encounters because I'm letting them happen. It's okay, I got plenty of antidotes too. It's actually the best thing you could have done to me. Because antidotes are super cheap, and I have a ton of them, and I doubt I'll ever get around to using them. Okay. Ahem. First of all, I also finally have a thing for this, which I'm gonna do later. I spent forever searching all the areas, and I just kept getting mail bug, mail bug, mail bug, mail bug. I finally had to look it up, and it's because I was thinking, are there any females of these? And it's apparently 1 in 8-ish, and I was like, oh, okay. But yeah, for a while I was thinking I was doing something wrong. There just wasn't any female bugs. I even started breeding. I've got back at the daycare. They're probably holding an egg for a whichever one of the bugs I left there. So anyway, that's a thing that has happened too. But I finally have one, so I can try to get the legendary big bug. Ooh, it's toasty in here. Perfect for a fiery hot Pokemon battle. You're not a fire breather. Yeah. That's not a fire type. What are you talking about? Oh, crud. This is not your matchup. For this, I think we want hot stuff. Actually, what I want to use is my Kirin. We'll put that one out next. Bonk. That hurt more than I thought it would. I was gonna make a snide remark, but never mind. You hit hard enough to, yeah. Oh crap, I can't Mega Evolve the Kirin now. Ah! What was I thinking? I wasn't thinking. And you have Sturdy, which is obnoxious. That's fairly effective! Looks pretty effective to me! Arr. Arr. Alright, Tarlard. Well, I guess I can just let the Frost Moth take this one. Since I can't Mega Evolve my Kirin right at the moment, we'll do that next battle. Good enough? Gotta be good enough. If it manages to pull off an Earth Tech, though, I'd be in trouble. I think Fairy's super effective against Dragon as well. I'm actually kind of, with the Kirin, I'm now stacked to fight dragons, actually. Oddly. Well, the fighting type. I guess this is the best I got, actually. My, flying type. I wish I had somebody with a psychic move. The three-leg thing just looks kind of strange. It feels like... It doesn't feel like you have one leg too many. It feels like you're missing a foot. I don't know why it is. Something's tickling at my mind, like I should know the reason that you're a three-legged Pokemon. You're a reference to something? Oh, well that's just rude. Now nobody gets the EXP. I'm sweating bullets. Say, trainer, we met before. You look familiar. We might have. Sweating bullets? That sounds like something I'd expect Schwarzenegger to do. The old Schwarzenegger, back in the day. Alright, let's see. Alright, next time we're gonna do the... Gonna use the Mega Evolved Kirin some. Yay! It's a Dusk Ball. This is a pretty epic victory road. So many different directions. That's a hat! Can I put the hat on my head? No, it's for Pokemon only. Oh. Interesting. It didn't even specify physical attacks only. See, if I wasn't running Repel, I would be getting all worn down. I wonder if they have different encounters in different parts of the cave. That Rocky Helmet's really interesting, but with Mega Evolutions taking up some of my slots, I don't really have a whole lot of them to spare. I don't have a lot of held item slots to go around right now, and I like leftovers a lot. So hot! Let's cool off with a refreshing battle! Okay. Imanu. The water type will be weak to freeze ray, but the fire half won't be, so it'll balance out, and then you'll hit me with a fire attack for 4x damage. Nope, there's no winning this. I don't really get the Nuzlocke runs. I mean, I get them, but at the same time, I don't quite get them. I've never tried it, so, you know, that might be part of it, but... how do I put this? On one hand... okay, on one hand, the catching thing I totally get. Like, you get... a lot of players otherwise would just play with the same Pokemon. They'd just choose the strongest ones each game, and, you know, like a lot of the Let's Plays would look very similar. So by having you work with random Pokemon that you catch, and not having the full selection... I get that part of it. Ooh, you're actually resistant. I just don't know the typing of Fairy very well. I probably should actually pull that up. Ooh, Feligar. Go ahead. Yep, the only Feligar I've seen before this was sleeping too. It's one of the rebattlers. He's done it every time. Well, that won't work. Let's try Moonblast. Anyway, what I don't get about the Nuzlocke challenge is the if you have a Pokemon faint, it goes down. Now, see, I don't think it would make for as good a... I mean, on one point, yes, it would make the battles more intense, because at any moment your Pokemon could just die on you. Like, something go wrong and you just have something die. But the way it encourages you, I would think, it encourages the player to over-level. Because you'd have to be over-leveled all the time. You couldn't do this crazy shit that I'm doing where you're, in many cases, under-leveled. You'd over-level and you'd be trying to, you know, you wouldn't be taking any risks ever. I don't know. I don't quite get it. I might try a Nuzlocke challenge someday in the future and see what it's like, but at the moment I'm a little dubious of it. Let's go ahead and throw that last Dragon Pulse in there. You can't use electricity on this thing. It doesn't work. Well, I guess we'll have to fly. Wait, what? But it used a body slam. You have Pixelate, but for electricity, don't you? I'll bet you do. Huh. That was very refreshing. Now that my Pokemon have fainted, I'll have to go back and heal them up again. Don't think this is the end of my challenge. So, yeah. Here... it seemed like Pixelate was a clever, special thing for the Metroid that would make it, you know, so all of its moves were... but no, turns out that, that ability has gotten around. It's too good an ability, you know? It's just so perfect. What about the other one? We'll just bicycle down another ladder. It's safe. We're very skilled bicyclists. Shame the only earth type I have already knows that move. Still, I like to have that TM. Blah. I like to have that TM. Because...
Well, because I like to swap around Pokemon a lot. Fire is my element. I live and breathe it. In this environment, you don't stand a chance. We're not in a fire of hell from the genius of Sephiroth. We're just in another cave. Funny how Victory Road loves to be caves. I've never seen you before, but I'm pretty sure that this is the wrong thing to fight you with. Hey, Gamma! I got a job for you. Isn't it amazing how just having a just two or three levels makes such a difference? That and having a few more options. I don't know, maybe the opponents just aren't of the same class. Maybe they put the worst things in Victory Road up front. As a kind of a gate. Like, if you can get past these terrors, then you're ready. That would make a lot of sense, because the further you get into it, the more going back to heal hurts, so you wouldn't want to. So by putting if you put the nastiest encounters up front, and that was worth almost no EXP in what? Oh. It is a straight up demon. Fallen Angel. Very classic. Where can I find one of these? I'm gonna check my Pokedex. Does it have a third stage? Tell me this thing has a third stage, or a Mega Evolution. Or both. Chimaconda, that doesn't sound like a... Yeah, that's just that. I mean, it's also a bit demonish, kind of, when you look at the head and all, but, oh, okay. Come on, hit! Hit! Got him. But yeah, I want the demon. I wanna know where I can get one. I wouldn't mind an angel to go with it, like an actual, typical, you know, traditional... Have you heard? They say this volcano has a guardian that lives deep inside, but has been asleep for hundreds of years. Yes! One of the legendaries is here, one of the legendaries is under the Ice Mountain. There's supposed to be those ones in the ninja's town, too, that they talked about. I didn't know I was in a volcano. Should have put some lava in here. Come on. Lava wouldn't have been that hard to find. It's so common, like every game has lava in it. Alright, let's see. Right, I remember. I am not as tired as I was in the last video, but I am kind of tired. Yes, definitely has another, unless it's a one-off. No, it's gotta be. Gotta have another form. Alright, little impy, where do you live? You live in here. Okay. Cool. And you probably have a third form, too. It's not a guaranteed thing, but it's probable. Huh. I wish. I've also seen your form that's one step up from this. Where is it? It seemed to be missing. Maybe it's somewhere else at a lower number in the dex for some reason. Okay. Are you the last one? I'm trying out a new lineup of Pokemon. Want to help me out? Don't hold back! I never hold back. Mercury, that's a cool name. Are you? I saw something like you, but I think you're a little different looking. You must be the evolved form of it. I mean, it's a physical move, but... Go ahead and try it. what I thought, your psychic type. If only I had a special bug. Oh. Okay. Right. Well, Neptune, I have bad news for you. Why did you choose Neptune to fight an ice bug? Doesn't seem like it would have type advantage to me. Anyway, amnesia won't save you! Oh boy. Amnesia, now there was an experience. That game. Whew. Oh, you have six! No trainer in here has had six before, and they're still up in the 60s. I hope this is a wise decision on my part. How does fairy react to fire? That's it. I gotta pull up types. I gotta specifically just fairy type. I have to know. Hold on, hold on, hold on. Fairy type. No, not types of fairy. Do I actually have to tell you, Pokemon? Come on, Google. You should know me by now. Bet some other search engine would have figured out what kind of things I search for by now. And know what I mean. Okay. Battle properties. Times 2 to Dark Dragon Fighting. 1/2 to Fire, Poison, Steel. Oh. See, I should have known that. Okay. It takes double damage from poison. Steel makes sense. Zero from dragon is immune? Why would a fairy be immune to dragons? I think dragons could eat fairies, honestly. Alright. I'm gonna keep this open because I'm not gonna remember this stuff. Resistant to bugs, I can kind of make sense of that. Resistant to dark, okay. Resistant to fighting. Kinda see that. It's abstract and weird, but okay. But why are fairies weak to poison? I swear, this type, they just said, we need dragons to have a weakness. And we need something that something else that poison is good against. And what looking at these pile, what could we name it and get away with? What if we name it fairy? When people question, yeah, we'll name it fairy. I don't know. Its resistances and weaknesses are very strange to me. And I have to survive a full-on battle of six. Okay, Chainite. What would be good against a ghost? Fire usually works pretty well. I don't know. Ice should work. And I want you to have more opportunities to level. I honestly don't have too good an idea of what this thing can really do. Ho, you made a mistake there. I really want to try bug because it's a ghost, but my physical's awful and there's just something weird about using physical attacks on a ghost. Oh no, you've disabled one of my moves. Oh, no. Oh, Luke. Oh, man. It would have been the perfect time, too, because it would have been crazy effective. Lucabra being a water and a grass being hit with that move. Oh. Let's give Stormringer another shot, eh? I don't know what triggers your evolution. Just hope it's... Oh, no, no, oh, no! I was thinking of... Ah! I was thinking of the grass water type I'm always using. Lucha Libre, you're... Okay, oops. Well, this isn't so good. I don't like this at all. How's that? That was no good. Alright, poison fighting. Poison fighting. Poison fighting. I mean, I could use fly, but that's... Stormbringers! It's just... It's kind of like a Pidgeotto right now. No amount of levels is going to make up for the fact that he's just not up there. By the way, poison? You can't poison an alien. His physiology isn't the same as yours. If you missed, that would have been terrible. Your earth poisons only work on other earth creatures. His physiology as it was developed to fight. You know, I don't have any problem taking down a Drillgan. What? But my hyper beam killed something. You shouldn't get a free turn. That's another thing about Nuzlocke run. Things like Horn Drill exist. I don't know, man. What can I say? They got me again. I'm not 100% certain of your typing. Not 100%. I think you're an Earth Steel, but I don't know. Oh, if I could Dragon Pulse you. Alright, go ahead. Try your drill. Oh, a Mega Hornet then. Doesn't matter. Got him. Thanks to the battle, I have a better idea of what my weak spots are now. I'll have to battle you again sometime once I create the perfect team. Yes, your weak points. Mostly you. Your skill. It's not up there. Not on the same level as me. I don't trust that I can cross through that door without something happening. I could suddenly trigger a cutscene that leads me straight into a battle, and I wouldn't... Gotta be ready for it. Even if it's ridiculously expensive. I gotta be ready for it. Ninjas? What are you doing here? Do you hear it? The furious howling of the wind. Well, okay. If I'd stepped between the two of them at once, would it have been a double battle? I don't think I want a double battle at the moment. Well, that one's level 64 and it's still a Voltasu. Blizzard. Hit! Yes! This thing is really fast. I expect ice types to be glacial in their movement speed. But no, actually, this thing is pretty fast. Water steel. Fire isn't super effective. I no longer have my fighting types. Crud. Oh, even Lucia. The grass type. That also had a drain punch. Even that's out. Maybe Earthquake? Fairies have a problem with cold iron, so. Don't bring the fairy out to fight steel. Got it. I can remember that detail. I need to remember that they're weak to poison for some reason. Okay. Bring it down quick.
Come on.
You can bring this thing down. Yeah. Man, what's Iron Head look like when it's actually very effective? Because all the time it's swinging in to be not very effective. Oof. We have fallen. We fight to maintain our clan's honor through victory in the championship. I still haven't seen the end of the Pirates storyline either. There's a lot of loose threads hanging right now. Becoming champion doesn't seem like it's gonna be the end, does it? The mountain rumbles underfoot. Your trial is now. Okay, Toru? Ah. Great. Well, this thing is weak to that thing. I guess I will risk a blizzard. Alright. And now you go down. Poison is not your friend, so, you've actually caught up. Actually, my little Metroid is falling behind. Okay. Swift! Hmm. Haven't seen that one before. Wow, that ups 3 stats. You'd think coiling up would be for, like, a single strike. It would have been like a, you know, kind of like a solar beam, except... yeah, leather wouldn't be part of it. Okay. We've already established Metroid trumps, Poison Fighter. Ooh, this one is nasty. It hits ridiculously hard, and then it lowers 2 of your stats. Defense and Special Defense. Though my Metroid has probably lost this one. It has absolutely wrecked this thing, so I feel good about this exchange. Fighting doesn't like fairy so much, even though the poison is its weakness. Alright. I kinda wanna do me first. I just wanna do it. Moonblast. Try this thing on for size. You think you look scary? Or got anything else for me? Drat. I want to keep going with my mega evolved pony. Our entire village is counting upon us. We must not fail. Well. You two are not as good as your gym leaders. Those two should come this way if they want to try to become a champ. They'd have a much better chance of succeeding. Alright, hyper potions. 1, 2, 3. Just guzzle them, guys. There's plenty more where that came from. Oh me, oh my! You certainly seem a familiar face! Shall we have a rousing battle, old sport? I literally just finished today. Goldcorn. Senior Goldcorn. No, I've seen... You're the one that I keep re-battling on the bridge! Or maybe it's your son I keep battling on the bridge. I think. I'll check my phone. Anyway. I literally just finished today. Right on the tip of my tongue, come on, brain. You just finished reading the book. How can you not have it, like, right there? Ugh. 1920s. The name, come on, brain. This is gonna drive me crazy. could I literally finish a book and then forget a name? It's named after the main character, The Great Gatsby. Man. Man, that was frustrating. I just finished The Great Gatsby, and Gatsby was always calling people old sport. It's like the heck I'm in, this guy's like, old sport. Like, eh. What are the odds of that? Kieran. I should give you the experience share. You're more useful anyway. Yes, let's do it. No sense holding back. I should have used me first. I gotta use it. It's just such a cool ability. It was kind of one of the reasons I wanted to use the Kiracorn. Or Minicorn, I think it was called at the time. I didn't know it was gonna Mega Evolve, but I was like, me first, that's awesome! And I need somebody who can use strength, and hey look, you can use strength. Alright, let's try it. Let's do it. That was weird. Oh. Well, that's not so great then. We live! Do it again! Go ahead. Flash cannon again. Try it! I don't even know how you just did that. It goes first, and it uses a more powerful version, though with the typing being off, that's probably just to offset the, you know. Because obviously this is the flying type, so it wouldn't be as good with that. And you are times 4 weak to fairy, aren't you? Which is why my Barrietty always lost against anything that was fairy type. Starting to figure this fairy type thing out. Goodness gracious! Great balls of fire. At least I had a dignified defeat. Suppose I'll see you again in the championship, old sport. Yeah, let's check. He always would say my Pokemon have become even more dignified. He had an Arbok in there. Yeah! Senior Goldcorn! You've changed your lineup some since I rebattled you just a little tiny bit ago. But I suppose you rich people can afford all the Pokemon you want, huh? You'd have to go out there and catch them yourselves. Actually, there's kind of an archetype for... Well, it's more of a hunter archetype, but, I shall defeat you with powers summoned from beyond this mortal coil. Magrat. I have one of those! It even has a special name. I never did get around to using it, though. How do you like that? Well, let's hope that the bug type hits harder. Ooh, crap. Maybe we're not gonna get a chance to. Okay, we will. Get him! Hit hard! No. But it's a ghost type. It's just is it mixed? Oh, well. That was an excellent chance for the Kiracorn to gain more EXP. It performs quite well. I am very impressed with this thing. It's also running out of moves. But I have elixirs. I brought them for good reason. I hope I don't have to leave and purchase more, more revives and heals. I'm at least getting good money. To you two. Chainite. There's actually not a lot of ghosts in this game. Like, the typing has been... Oh, hello. The typing has been really interesting and all, but, not seen so much with the ghosts. Hmm. Well, okay. Well, go butt heads with it. You sound really silly when you do that. Crud! Don't heal! That's my ability! Okay. Survive, survive. Ah, oh, you didn't survive. Just go faster than it. Wow, we're fighting something that's mega evolved. Sort of. Alright, and now the twisted dimensions return to normal. Alright, here comes out the chainite. Fire blast? Weird. Normally I consider Fire Blast to be this super heavy-handed attack. It's unfortunately inaccurate, but then I've got this actual, even more heavy-handed attack that's also more accurate. It's a terrible drawback, but still. It's odd looking at Fire Blast. It's just... I really wish I had Flamethrower in there. I've replaced Fire Blast straight up with it. Because... Spirits, why have you forsaken me? Because I beat them up and chased them off. Heed my prophecy. A great reckoning approaches. Something wicked this way comes. Oh, joy. Is it the pirates? No, it's probably my mother. Probably mad about what I did to her radioactive team. Oh, boy. Let's save. I've only had the game crash that one time, but that's one time too many. Anyone wanna power up their normal type techs? Not really. I mean, I could put it on my pony, but... Ooh, that's what I'm talking about! Look at that! Let's surf in it! Let's get waterfall and go up the waterfall. There's a lot of spots where there's waterfalls in the game. I can't get over that. There's gotta be a way to jump over there. You didn't see me because I was hiding! I love going behind big rocks! You utterly failed. You needed a bigger rock if you were gonna do that. Well... You're a bug type, so you're weak to ice. And you're a water type, so you're weak to freeze dry. So, 4x? Go down? You survive somehow. I like 4x. I like 4x in Pokemon. I like 4x games like Master of Magic. I've yet to find something with 4x attached to it that I don't like. Villa card. We're up to level 65 enemies now. They keep going up. It was 60 when I first entered Victory Road, and I'm out of blizzards. So, freeze dry? It's not going to be good enough. And it will heal with its attack, because it has bloodlust. Yep. I feel like I'm slowly... Like, I had done that work to level up, and I feel like I'm slowly getting caught back up with... Alright. Ever there was a time for you, it is here. Come on. You could do better than that. This is not the time for you. Okay. Understood.
If I only had just a straight up rock. if I just had a rock in my party,
it'd just be like, what? That doesn't hurt me. That's what we need. Oh dear, how are we gonna do this? Alright. You're a better electric type than Stormbringer, which is a little bit sad. Ugh. See, you know, I think this thing is really awesome. Like, this villa card is just amazing. Oh man, survive. Don't be critted. Okay. It's okay. I am guzzling these things like water. Okay, we can give you another shot. Come on. Come on, survive. Survive. Oh, you didn't! Gah! Alright. I don't know why I always wait for the Z before to appear in the inventory before I hit it for Mega Evolving, but I do. I always do. I was at first thinking of starting with the overheat, but I think it'd be better to start with... Perfect! Never mind, I don't even have to talk about what my strategy or thinking was any further. That did it. Well, Achilles! Hey, buddy! I want to see what you Mega Evolve into, but I don't think anyone's ever going to show me. Bye. It's no good. It's no use. Let's just flush you into the lava. Seriously, there's no surviving that. I wish I still had my Achilles. Guess I wasn't fast enough. If you ask me, what the most important stat is, it's speed, without a doubt. Going faster than your opponent is a key to winning battles. It really is critical. You can see when I have a Pokemon and they don't go first, sometimes they just straight up lose because of that. It is such a big deal. Most turn-based games, speed isn't this important. Pokemon. It's pretty critical. I should let the, I'm running low on these, but... Alright, let's try an elixir. One for you. And one for you. I will splurge. I mean, it's Victory Road. What else? Where else? If I don't splurge here, where else am I going to? But yeah, I bet there's unique Pokemon here. Like the Demon Imp. Legends tell of a great conflict atop of Mount Actonite. Could it be this one? What, you think that your battle with me is the stuff of ancient legends? Well, it's obviously not, because you led with Barrand. So there's no chance that anyone's going to talk about this fight. Seriously. Barrand, what are you thinking? That's more like it. So you only bring three Pokemon to the fray, and one of them was Barrand. By the way, 4x damage. Try another one. What can I say? When the ice moth works, it works. Quiver Dance? Well... performs a beautiful dance to boost its special attack, special defense, and speed. Well, you know, I don't think I'll ever use it, but I might. Ice Ball, on the other hand, I will never use because your physical attack is sad. Why not? Ooh. That was a stupid opening move. There are places where it's theoretically useful, but I never get why anyone would use Endure. Like, I mean, if you saw a solar beam coming or something, but I don't know, maybe in the PvP scene it has its place. I don't know. I've never played Pokemon competitively. I mean, obviously, look at how terrible I am at it. That was a bit of an anticlimax. We're not at the top of Mount Actinite. The league is close to the top, and the championship's arena is at its peak. Awesome. Alright, I think you've held this long enough. But I want you to do Mega Evolutions. And I'm pretty happy with you having my amulet coin right now. And leading with you. Alright, fine. Whatever. Gotta evolve sometime. You have to. It's gotta come. I know that it has a big epic super evolution. Like, I should go back to the Ninja Town and show you guys the statue of it. I should probably look it up, really. I can take this. I can take this. No, wait. What about Blizzard? I don't have anyone particularly resistant to Blizzard other than hot stuff. But you're weak to Blizzard. All that just to put hot stuff back at the back to riding shotgun. Look, Alice, it's another traitor to add to our victory list. I wonder if they can handle our flawless teamwork. Alright. It'd be better if you had evolved your Neopunk as well. Alright. Blizzard's not really the right move for this, but we'll go with it anyway. Yeah! Dig! It's brilliant! I mean, I planned that all along. Yeah, Frostra, you think you're fast. How are you faster than us? Instant crush. It's a quick attack. I see. Crap! Ah! Well, that was unfortunate and embarrassing. Alright. Guess another Blizzard and you're done. I wish you could dig. Guess you'll have to make do with an earthquake. Which would kill Frostra, so it's not so wise either. Alternate. Ah! We're not meant to fight together! We'll destroy each other! I should just risk it. Yeah, I was thinking you might try another instant crush thing. Okay. So that means the surf was the right move. How did I predict you'd go for the moth, huh? You want to hit the thing that's the softest and easiest to knock out. Well. Oh, crud, how are you still standing? Alright, it's got a quick attack. But I have me first! Now, which wins? Instant Crush or me first? Well, I wasn't expecting that. Huh. That just works generally on both of them? Interesting. Make sure that goes down, please. Survive, 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 survive. Ugh. Thank you. You're supposed to me first! Does it not work in a multi-battle? I suppose it's possible. What? Oh. Something else. A demon unicorn, huh? Oblivicorn is a cool name. I wonder what all you do. Well, you're probably a dark type, so a Moonblast would do well, but I'll make another attempt at me first. And a Surf. Okay. Well, me first just doesn't work in multi-battles, I guess. Alright, Escartris, please withstand whatever hits. Yes! Even better, dodge it! This is not an easy battle. Good, good, good. Alright. I have no idea how this will work out. I guess Swift and Surf. No matter who you take down, you're gonna get hurt. But it won't be enough to bring you down. Huh. That was unwise of you. Oh no. I bring down my own Metroid for you. Oh no, I don't. We win! Oh! Not worth per- oh, okay. Oh, man. Oh, hey. What? You beat us? I gotta admit, you're good, alright. How many people could overcome our Prazeopunk Neopunk combo? You must be really talented. I can see why most people would lose to that. That and the fact that you're really, really high level. Okay. That was actually a close fight. I thought for sure Stormbringer was going to come in at the end. I honestly don't know what to do with it. If I leave this place to restock, I'll probably just put it up and pull out good old grass water. Lucha Libre? I think it's called Lucha Libre. There's got to be a way to jump. You know, I'm going to come back to catch Pokemon later. Yes! Thank you. Why couldn't you just sell that in a store? I've been needing that. I've been calling that one by name for a while. Crap, what was the number on it? I didn't catch it. It's one of the classic ones. Okay. Hot stuff. I'm trading out Fire Blast for Flamethrower. I just want the accuracy. Overheat is already filling the role of Fire Blast. High risk, high reward. There's a way to jump. I know there is. Is that going to be my TM here? Bounce? Bounce is already an attack in the game, isn't it? Well, that doesn't have much. Or maybe I'll do something to put the lava out. Am I gonna fight something like a Moltres that's making all the lava? strength. I'm so glad I did bring strength. Oh, of course. Huh, it plugged the hole. Interesting. That means I can't just jump down the hole, though. Hmm. Okay, so now I should be able to cross the streams. And it's one of the few circumstances where you'd say cross the streams and not be making a Ghostbusters reference. Oh, boy. Alright. And up. It knows I'm going through them, so it put one here for me, eh? We must be nearing the top of this now. This has been pretty epic. Alright, let's see. You don't need that, because you don't really... I'm going to stick you to special. So, actually, you... Oh. Really? Oh! Boy! Hmm. That's odd. Hmm. Okay, I know where this goes now. I'm sure I'll find somebody that'd be happy to eat the protein later. Mm. I wonder how many super repels I have. Oh! That's not it. Hmm. Is it up here? Ah, okay. So now... Just push this rock with my bicycle. Just nudge it with that front tire. Everybody's done this. Pushed rocks with bikes. Okay. So now... Should be here. Alright, don't tell me there's any more trainers past this point. No trainer got past that. Come on. Nobody got past that. I don't know what the Elite Four was thinking. Probably thinking they'd just get people who could hop. They'd just go bonk bonk. Wait, what did I just find? Crap, I wasn't paying enough attention, I guess. Oh well. Let's go. Not ominous in the least! Okay. Let's enjoy the view from up here amid the flowers. I can only see rock ledges. The rock ledges are obscuring my view! Oh boy. I used the last of my super repels. Okay guys, come on, you always, always give me a healing point before the Elite Four. You can't hold that out on me. Haha, I flagged you. I can fly away right now and heal. No, I will trust you. Huh. This building looks very old. Like they built this in old times, the classical world. I wonder, will we see any nuclear Pokemon in the arena? Given the way things have gone lately, I would assume you'd see a lot of those. An arena. Not your typical Elite Four, eh? I don't think Maria's gonna win it again this year. There's this new trainer, and everyone says they're scary strong. If you ask me, they're almost a guarantee. Do you know what the new trainer's specialty is? I can't find any info on them in the database. Hey, wait a sec, you look kind of familiar. Oh my gosh, it's you! Wow! Oh no, you're gonna repeat? Come on, after that, you have to have something new to say. I'm Maria's biggest fan. One time she signed my arm. That was the bestest day of my life. Thandor's League is quite different, isn't it? Which gym leader gave you the most trouble? I had a tough time against Rosalind. Her disguises really tripped up my team. Oh, are you a trainer? Would you allow us to interview you for a news story? Okay. This is Gabby reporting live from the Thandor Championship. Didn't I see you on TV way back at the beginning? I'm sure I did. The air in here is crackling with energy. I can almost taste these trainers' determination. However, only one of them will come out on top. Who will it be? Here with me is one of the trainers who will be taking the challenge. Tell me, what is your name? I was warned something wicked this way comes. I'm willing to bet we're going to see possibly pirates, but almost certainly a legendary nuclear atomic doom thing will land and attack us in the middle of it. Wait a minute, Hadrix? Isn't the same Hadrix to put a stop to the power plant attacks? Wow, you're a national hero. Wow, somebody is actually giving me respect for things I did. Usually it's like, I just stopped all of Team Rocket and freed a city. Nobody has anything to say about that anywhere in the world? Okay then, I guess I did it quietly. Of course, a powerful trainer like you, it's only natural you'd end up here. Well, someone like you in the running, there's no doubt about it. We're in for a thrilling championship. And cut. Oh, I so hate having to smile and be nice all the time. I hope they break your legs. I want to see blood in this tournament. Okay. Yes, viewers from all over Thandor will be rooting for me. Yes, yes, I'm sure. Okay.
What do you think's gonna win the championship this year? My bet's on Maria. She won last year, after all.
Why is everyone talking about Maria?
The Thandor Championship is structured like a single elimination tournament. 32 trainers go in, one trainer emerges. 32, 16, 8, 4, 2. 5 rounds. Classic, okay. Please tell me I get to actually use the healing machine in between rounds, because that'd be awesome.
Yeah, for the honor of my village, I fight in the Thandor Championships. The gods will guide me to victory.
And what do you lot have to sell?
Yes, I need Pokeballs for this tournament, of course!
Okay, I think what I need is to replenish my hyper potions. I'm clearly not ready for this.
Anyone who wishes to challenge a champion needs to battle their way through Victory Road first.
Yes, any person who's arrived here knows that, man.
That sparkle in your eye. You're planning to become the champion, aren't you?
Isn't everybody who's fighting here?
Oh, good luck.
I've never seen so many strong trainers in one place before. What is this? What is this? Just a dead-end hallway with a bunch of golden Pokeballs?
Is that the only kind of art you have in your world to display Pokeballs? Well, I mean, there's a painting up there. I'm not quite sure what's going on in that painting. Looks like it might be a Minecraft painting. Whoa! Ah! Cool! It's a proper Colosseum! That must be rich people's seating, so they're real close to the action. But they have glass in front of them to prevent things from hurting them. Meanwhile, everybody else in the bleachers, they just have to deal with the flying rocks and fire. This shuttle goes back to the train station in Legantown. Would you like to ride? Nah, I can fly, thanks. Alright, two things. First of all, my three-legged crow seems to be a failure thus far. I know you've got a third form in you. We'll go ahead and I'll show you a statue real quick. I should look this thing up. I mean, I should just ask the internet about this thing. There's got to be a trick to evolving it that I just don't know. It's not any of the stones, at least none of the stones I have. It might be a stone dome, but it could be a held item. It could be a held item while trading. Ugh. Like, how would you ever know that kind of stuff unless somebody tells you? And none of the ninjas told me anything about how to evolve it, but I'm certain this thing, Yatagaryu, is the sacred Pokemon only proven can train them. Summon thunderstorms, that's why they call it the Stormbringer Pokemon. I'm sure you're supposed to be that. Alright, let me ask the internet. Cause before I tackle the Tournament of Doom, the Stormbringer Pokemon. Stormbringer ability? Stormbringer weather condition? Yatagaryu, that's the thing we're looking for. It evolves from a Voltasu starting at level 66. You know what's embarrassing? This? My gosh, it's the highest level thing in my party, too! Oh my gosh. Does Yatagaryu, do I happen to have a mega evolving stone for, do I have any for the Ice Moth either? Where's my Ites? They're in this category. Bariat, Whimsiscotite. Arbokite. No, I don't think so. So I don't think it'll mega evolve or anything. Or if it does, I don't have the ability to do that yet. There's at least one mega evolution thing that's at least one that's in the shop at the top floor of the one building. Anyway, okay. So, I'm not gonna win. Then again, we might not have a tournament at all. It might start and then immediately get crashed. This team, I mean, I really should think about it more. There's obvious holes in it. I know I'm gonna fight uranium types, and the dual typing is automatically super weak against radiation. All right. Oops, what did I go here for? This is wrong. All right, here's what we're gonna do. One level. That's not too hard. Okay. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna immediately grab that level. I should level up the Kieran and The metro. I should level up everything. Oh, I can't bicycle here. Alright, we're gonna grab this level very quickly off of some random Pokemon. Catch us a demon if we can, or anything else interesting. And then we're gonna go into the tournament. Why are you here? I'll also take a little time to go through the TMs. One of mine knows that move. Wait, was it faster than you? Your wings don't even look like they can support your weight. Okay, come on. You look like you're worth some EXP! I'm also not entirely confident in this thing's ability to beat you, so... Hot stuff! The floor is yours! You know what I need to do? I need to put that fairy type back up also, because I should have that plainly visible. It's one annoying thing about RPG Maker games. When you click out of them, it pauses. It's annoying. It's just annoying. I'm sure most people don't mind. It's probably even a nice feature for some players, but for me, with my Let's Playing, I, you know, want to click outside sometimes. Alright. Are we close? Oh, hey! You're really low level. I don't want you to pass out on me. That's intimidating. You say so, game. Well, I bet I can catch you without even hurting you. Though with what? Have an Ultra Ball. I'll splurge on you. You can live in this now. Check out your new home! It's got yellow on it and gray on it. It'll keep the rain out. Very good since you have fire on your head. And I assume you like to have fire on your head. Fire dark type. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that makes perfect sense for its typing. Pokemon is said to come from a separate plane of existence. It is very curious about the world around it, and delights in eating human flesh, because it is a demon after all. It's curious to know how everybody tastes. Good. We're getting there, and there might still be new and interesting monsters in this cave that we have not yet seen. So I wanted to make sure I did spend time walking around the lava a bit, looking at stuff. I still swear this thing's a Tenga... Like, it's a Gurrenlagen reference. God, Tenga Topa Gurrenlagen, right? Is that right? Or am I misremembering the name somehow? Here, you really need some levels. This tournament is gonna tear me apart. But I'm still betting that it gets interrupted. I'm still betting that this tournament gets interrupted at some point. Like I said, we have too many unresolved plot threads going around. Beep. You have a scary cry there, Stormbringer. Oh, now you're faster than it. Well, good. Maybe that last one was just hasty. See, I mean, I could go to the ninjas to do a bunch of quick fights with one of them, but, I don't think Stormbringer would be particularly effective against any of them. Like, each of the six ninjas, I think I mentioned this, they each just have one Pokemon that they throw at you, like 5 times. I think you guys saw the one that was nothing but Dunsparces. They're not very fun or interesting battles. They're actually really tedious. I've used the one with the stone gargoyle so much for leveling because I've run a lot of water and grass types. I kind of miss the Gyarados. He was just underperforming consistently though. But I kind of want to get a radioactive type back in the crew. I should stop this train of logic now before I spend another bajillion hours leveling. Cause yeah. I have spent way too much time grinding in this game off camera. Alright, we're getting there. Very soon. Almost got it. I'm also about ready to give up on this location as a place where I'll find interesting new Pokemon. It's kind of unfortunate because here we are, right at the cusp of the Elite Four. Shouldn't there be something new and exciting? I mean, the Imp is pretty cool. I definitely want to check out evolving one of those up, but let's go upstairs to where I dropped the rocks down from and see if we get anything else. I'd suggest that Stormbringer could use the EVs, but it can't even use a protein for some reason? Alright. And Peck it. Seriously, you should have not Drill Peck, like some other form of Ultra Peck. Hardcore Peck, because that beak looks like it's designed for caving in, pretty much anything that really that you hit it with. I would not want to be struck in the head by that beak. Why are you giving me the things that are worth almost no EXP, game? Come on! Is there any rares in this place? Yeah, try a shockwave. It's good enough for you. And you had better live up to my expectations, bird. You had better become as big and awesome as I'm hoping you do. Don't disappoint me. Seriously, I have leveled you and leveled you and leveled you. I don't know, maybe in the later Pokemon games there's stuff that evolves at levels like this, but I have never seen a Pokemon that needed to be level 67 to evolve that I can remember. Unless I'm mistaken and Dragonite was level 70. But I think Dragonite evolved at level 60. I think. And to me, that's always been like my mental bar of a ridiculously high level Pokemon evolution. Come on, you gotta be right on the cusp here. I'm guessing 2 more non-imp battles. The imps don't count, because they're worth crappy EXP. That's my guess. Okay, right. To go further up was around the other way. Alright. Well, it's a shame. I was hoping for something big and impressive. Possibly that didn't even have an evolution tree. But, no. Oh well. Fan games, I find, are less likely to make ridiculously rare. I mean, you still find rare Pokemon, but they tend to be less ridiculously rare. I'm not wording this well. I'm not making sense. Like, in the Pokemon games, the official Nintendo games, sometimes you'd be wandering around and around for like an hour in an area just trying to get a Pokemon to spawn. Pikachu in Viridian Forest comes to mind, as literally it's taken me more than an hour to get one sometimes, and I've done that so... I've replayed the classic games so many times in my life. But, there are others... Oh, come on, give me the last Pokemon! This is the last battle here. Oh! Okay, there was a super rare here, but I've already got your previous form. But yeah, fan games tend, I find, to not do that as much. I guess that fan game authors don't really expect their players to spend quite the same amount of time that Nintendo does. And perhaps maybe not trade with each other so much as Nintendo does. Expects their fans to. That's just a guess. Maybe fan authors just want the player to see all the cool stuff that they made. Alright. Thunderbolt didn't quite do it. We'll try a Swift. Oh, that shouldn't work. Oh well. Not even your alien morphology can handle toxic, apparently. Okay, this has got to be it. Evolve time. Yes! It works! It looks kind of like it's a dragon. What was it? Was it the Korean dragons? No, wait. Which dragon has three claws on its body? Oh, I don't remember. You're still kind of birdish, kind of electric-ish, but you're shaped like a dragon now. So, electric flying. Okay. Oh no, electric dragon! Huh, you lost a flying type. Is that a mustache? Looks like you have a mustache. Okay. The Pokemon starts a thunderstorm if it appears in battle. I wonder what type of moves it could learn now. Okay, okay, let us immediately dig through our TMs. Okay, I have a dragon move, Corrosive Breath. I've never had anything that could learn this. You need a breath weapon. Tough. Well, that's not very helpful to me. Well, that's not a very good technique. Huh. Alright, this defense, special defense is okay and all, but let's see what else we got here. Flash cannon. What about... I know I have Dragon Claw in here somewhere. I have Dragon Pulse. It already knows Dragon Pulse. Dragon Claw is near the very top. Yeah, there it is. Alright, how does Dragon Claw relate? It's an 80... I kind of want to give you thunder. Ugh, stop it! No! Oh crap, that's what I keep doing. Okay. Okay, back up. I'm more tired than I think I am. That's all. Alright, is this what I'm gonna attempt this with? Is this really what we're gonna go with, this team? I need to check one more thing. Okay, you're more of a special attacker, though your attack is good too. Your stats are just strong. Still, you're a little bit more leaning towards the special attack. I kind of want you to keep Roost, but I kind of want to throw Roost out for Thunder. I think you're okay. I think this party is good to go. I just really should take more time to level up Frostthra. Should be at least 60. Given the terrors that I've seen so far, I should take a little time to level up more. I can do the rebattle circuit again. Next time! Next time we enter the championship. Oh, what? Hello? What? No! I was gonna save! Don't interrupt! What? Hadrix! Hadrix! You didn't think I was gonna miss your league challenge, did you? I came as fast as I could when I heard you were making your way through Victory Road! There's no way I'd miss this! After all, I was there when it all began. Hadrix, I know I haven't always been there for you. I realize that now, but I'm determined to make up for it. I promise I won't miss a minute of your rise to glory. After all, you're my child. Actually, that has nothing to do with it. I'm just amazed that you're so powerful and awesome. I didn't care about you when you were just weak. Now I'm proud. Now that you're amazing. Have you seen Theo? I thought he'd be here somehow. Theo and Cameron left Ranger HQ some time ago. I too thought they'd be here, but I guess not. After all, they're both still recovering from their battles against Kiri. He knows things. He knows things about Kiri. And he has his own evil plots to attend. He still hasn't returned that radioactive material, has he? Hey, wait up! You thought you were gonna challenge the League without me? As if I'd make it that easy on you, Hadrix. We're rivals! So that means wherever you go, I'll be there too! I will be watching as well, of course. I fully expect you to both. Fully expect to see both of you make it to the final round. Haha, you can bet on me, Dad! I sabotaged all the other trainers, just like you taught me. I mean, we will fight honorably, alright, Hadrix? See you in the arena. Okay. After all this time and everything he's been through, he's still filled with energy. That kid's fighting spirit can't be stopped. If it comes down to you and Theo in the finals, Hadrix, I wonder which of you will come out on top. Seriously? Has he ever beaten me? Come on now! Come on now, Bambo! Come on now! You really haven't been paying any attention to me at all, have you? Only time will tell. Anyway, let's make our seats. Good luck out there. Okay, saving. Next time! On Pokemon Uranium. Who knows what will happen. Until then and every time. I also have training to do. I need my Pokemon to be in tip-top shape as well. This is Hadrix, signing off. Because I'm a dirty, rotten cheater, I'm doing something dirty and rotten and cheating. I go change the date and time. Oh my gosh, it's now Wednesday. I've been going through the whole week like this. I'm up to Wednesday now. Shop sells different things on Wednesday. I suppose I could use a dusk stone. Okay. Don't have one of those, since it's one of the three starters. And now I do it again! Yes, why not? Anyway. So, shopping. I'll have more stuff. Week's worth of shopping complete. All preparations good to go. The championship won't know what hit him.